Helvetia was created after the Civil War. West Virginia was a brand new state and looking to increase its population. And the Swiss were highly thought of. They're self-sufficient, very ingenious, very well-educated. So the government officials actually hired a gentleman. He went to the German-speaking part of Switzerland and recruited folks to come out. A group of them decided they wanted to investigate this West Virginia place and see if it was someplace that they wanted to settle. And you've got to remember, this is virgin wilderness. Nothing is here. And they decided that, yes, they did want to pursue settling here and making this their home. It's not an easy place to get to. You have to go over and up and down multiple mountains on not the best of roads. They're narrow and they're curvy. Just that isolation makes it very difficult sometimes to bring new things in. So part of the fact that a lot of those traditions are still here is just because there was not a way for them to leave.
Helvetia is like a beautiful mixture of Swiss and Appalachian. My grandmother was Eleanor Farner Mayhew, and her father was Swiss, and he immigrated here. He was a first-generation American. On my mother's side, everyone has basically grown up here. Fasnacht is a Swiss tradition. The root of the word is fasting night. In Helvetia, the Swiss settlers brought this festival from Switzerland with them when they first founded the community in 1869. It's a tradition that you practice before Lent, and what you do is you're essentially gorging yourself and having excess right before you're going to be very austere or deny yourself of something. So throughout the day, the Hütte restaurant is open, as well as the Culture House, which houses the Mask Museum. Those two locations are kind of the heart of our community, and they welcome people with food and beautiful masks from the previous year and things like that. Along with those two locations, the Starband Hall, which is our Red Hall, will be hosting a live mic. You can play music and participate, and that one's very informal and very casual and nice and relaxing. At 8:30 p.m., everyone will don their masks and gather a lampion, which will be candlelit, and they'll parade from the Starband Hall to our Helvetia Community Hall, where Old Man Winter hangs in the center of the hall, and the band is playing beautiful music. And then everyone takes off their masks, and we have a big dance, several square dances, polkas, waltzes, things like that. And if you don't know how to dance, it doesn't matter, because somebody's going to teach you. And then at the stroke of midnight, the band asks someone to cut down Old Man Winter, and they carry him off to the bonfire and hoot and holler and burn him away. That is supposed to say, welcome spring, get out of here winter, and that's the end. So here's Sophia's.
That's we had my rainbow leopard mask.
Lucy, what's yours?
Diver fish.
A scuba diver fish. She's gonna wear a little swimsuit and she's gonna wear a leopard outfit. You have to really fight to maintain a tradition, but I think that what's really cool about Helvetia is we're super stubborn and we want to hold on to this Swiss identity. The thing is, we see the value of holding on to some of these traditions that speak to your soul and that elevate your experience of life. So I think that's why we continue to do it.
Fasnacht for me is a way to share some history and just to have some fun. And I think a lot of folks come because it's a unique event and it's a West Virginia event, and we can enjoy it and share it while it's still here, and hopefully it'll be here for years to come.